Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ. And a most warm welcome for all of you joining us for this live broadcast of the traditional weekly appointment with Pope Francis and all of our brothers and sisters here in St. Peter's Square for the recitation of the Angelus on this 33rd Sunday in Ordinary Time and the 6th World Day of the Poor. On behalf of Vatican News, a warm welcome to all of you tuning in from all times of the day, every area of the globe. Some of you we know tuning in through our very own Vatican media channels, through our Vatican News app, our Vatican radio app, perhaps through our English Vatican News web portal, our YouTube channel, or our Facebook Live feed. We also have many of you tuning in through television. To all of our television viewers out there, some of you tuning in through Catholic TV, at Madarshan TV, Catholic Faith Network, EWTN, Salt and Light Media. And we have radio listeners out there as well. Some of you tuning in through Luminous Radio or other shortwave radio or diocesan radio stations, other local radio stations picking up this broadcast. And to all of you joining us through other digital platforms, welcome to you all. My name is Sister Bernadette, and it's a pleasure for me to provide the English language a translation for you this morning. Our Holy Father has presided over Mass for this 6th World Day of the Poor, which he himself instituted at the end of the extraordinary Jubilee of Mercy, recommending that it be celebrated on the 33rd Sunday of Ordinary Time, for he says it's a good day just before the feast of our Lord Jesus Christ, King of the Universe. It's a good time for us to reflect on what we have done to the poor, how we have served our Lord in the least of our brothers and sisters. As we know, when he comes as King of the Universe, he himself told us in the Gospel of St. Matthew that we will be judged according to how we have served him in our brothers and sisters. We now have our eyes turned on this window, just as our brothers and sisters here in St. Peter's Square, where we await our Holy Father, who will shortly be coming out to this balcony. We'll hear his words, and we will also receive the apostolic blessing, which, of course, there is an indulgence attached to, which also applies to those of us who are tuning in through these various forms of media. We see in the background the temporary medical clinic set up. Those who are in need are able to receive examinations there, as well as other services in these past few days and today as well. Our Holy Father now coming to us through the window and greeting everybody who is here today.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno, buona domenica.
Dear brothers and sisters, buongiorno and a good Sunday to you all. Today's Gospel takes us to Jerusalem, in the most place, in the temple. There around Jesus, some people speak about the magnificence of that grandiose building, adorned with costly stones, but the Lord states there will not be left a stone upon another that will not be thrown down. He then adds to the story, explaining how in history almost everything collapses. There will be, he says, revolutions and wars, earthquakes and famines, pestilence and persecution. And so he goes ahead as if to say, one should not place too much trust in earthly realities which pass. These are wise words which can, however, make us somewhat bitter. There are already many things going wrong. Why does the Lord even make such negative pronouncements? And so we can ask ourselves this. In reality, His intention is otherwise, to give us a valuable teaching, that is, the way out of all this precariousness. And what is the way out? How can we get out of all of these passing things that won't be anymore? It lies, perhaps, in a word that surprises us. Christ reveals it in the final phrase of today's gospel when he says, "By your perseverance, you will secure your lives." Perseverance. What is perseverance? The word indicates being very strict. But strict in what sense? With oneself, considering ourselves not up to standard? No. With others, becoming rigid and inflexible? Not this either. Jesus asks us to be strict, uncompromising, persistent in what He has at heart, in what really counts. Because what really counts very often does not coincide with what attracts our interest. Like those people at the temple, we often prioritize the work of our hands, our successes, our religious and civil traditions, our sacred and social symbols. These things are important, but they pass away. Instead, Jesus says to concentrate on what remains, to avoid devoting our lives to building something that will be destroyed in the end, like that temple, and forgetting to build what will not collapse, to build on His Word, to build on His love, on His goodness. This doesn't pass. To be persevering, to be strict in building what doesn't pass away. This, then, is perseverance. Building goodness every day. To persevere is to remain constant in goodness, especially when the reality around us urges us to do otherwise. So let's make a few examples. I know that prayer is important, we all know this, but like everyone, I too always have a lot to do, and so I put it off. I'm too busy, I can't, I'll do it later. Or I see many crafty people who take advantage of situations, who dodge the rules, and so I too stop observing them and persevering in justice and legality. Well, if these people do it, why can't I? Let's be aware of this. And again, I carry out service in the church for the community, for the poor, but I see that many people in their free time think only of enjoying themselves, and so I feel like giving up and imitating them. I don't see the results, or it's boring, or it doesn't make me happy. I don't know. Persevering, instead, is remaining in goodness. Let's ask ourselves, what is my perseverance like? Am I constant, or do I live faith, justice, and charity according to the moment? I pray if I feel like it. I'm fair, willing, and helpful if it suits me. Whereas, if I'm dissatisfied, if no one thanks me, I stop. Do I get bored? In short, do my prayer and service depend on circumstances, or do they depend on a heart that is steadfast in the Lord? If we persevere, as Jesus reminds us today, we have nothing to fear, even in the sad and ugly events of life, not even in the evil we see around us, because we remain grounded in the good. Dostoevsky wrote, "Have no fear of men's sin. Love a man even in his sin, for that is the semblance of divine love and is the highest love on earth." A quote from the Brothers Karamazov. Perseverance is the reflection in the world of God's love, because God's love is faithful, it's persevering, it never changes. May Our Lady, Servant of the Lord, persevering in prayer, fortify our constancy.
Et concepit de Spiritu Sancto.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus e benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mihi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus e benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitabit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitris.
Ut digni exiciamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratia tua, an quae sumus Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, ut angelo annunciante, Christi fili tui, incarnazione coniovimus, per passionem eius et crucem, a resurrectione gloriam perducamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et lux perpetua lucea eis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Adiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen.
And the crowd reacting now to having received our Holy Father's blessing from the Lord. Dear brothers and sisters, tomorrow is the first anniversary of the launching of the Laudato Si platform, which recommends that we work together with creation. We're talking about 6,000 people are participating, including individual persons, families, and association family, religious families. It's a beautiful initiative which will be going over a 7-year period, corresponding or responding to the cry of the earth and the cry of the poor. This is a crucial work for the future of humanity, and he hopes that it will become concrete dedication for everyone for the care of creation. And in this prospect, I want to remember the COP27 on climate, which is taking place in Egypt. I hope that they might take steps forward courageously, determinedly, in constancy or with the Paris Accord. We remain close to our brothers and sisters in the tortured or war-torn Ukraine, close in prayer, solidarity, and concrete solidarity. Peace is possible. Let's not resign ourselves to war. I greet all of you, pilgrims from Italy and from various countries, parishes, single members of the faithful. In particular, I greet the charismatic group from the United States of America. And he's looking at a group from Uruguay who've brought their bandoneon, a group from Paris, representatives of an educative group, members of a community from Milan, and he assures their prayer for their country, Eritrea, and he welcomes the altar servers,
la protezione civile di Lecco,
and other places from Italy, faithful of various other places in Italy. And as always, he greets those who participate in this Immaculate group. I hope all of you have a good Sunday. Please do not forget to pray for me. Enjoy your meal and arrivederci. We'll see each other again. As always, the final words of our Holy Father at this Angelus. And we now bring this live broadcast of the Angelus on this 33rd Sunday of Ordinary Time to an end. We invite you to go to our Vatican News web portal, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and Twitter accounts. You'll find full coverage of today's liturgy and Angelus, as well as other Vatican and world news. We will be back on Wednesday for the general audience, and next Sunday, our Holy Father will celebrate the liturgy of Christ the King from Asti in northern Italy, where he will be going to visit a cousin of his. On behalf of Vatican Media, I'd like to thank the production staff here in studio. We have Father Felipe Herrera, our coordinator, and Gustavo Messina, our audio technician. And once again, all of our media partners, Catholic TV at Madarshan TV, Catholic Faith Network, EWTN, Salt and Light Media, and Luminous Radio. And for all others who've brought this broadcast to you, and thank you all for joining us in this weekly appointment with our Holy Father, in which we remember the incarnation of the Son of God through Our Lady's Yes. Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ.